Hey, SGI fam. My name is Jared, one of the coaches here, and we are just, we're thinking about you guys a lot. I was on a phone call earlier today and couldn't help but find myself in your shoes as well as I can. Back in the late 2007, 8, 9 timeframe, we had the housing crisis, right? You know, all of a sudden the economy tanked, maybe not quite as suddenly as now, but I remember leading my companies through that in that crazy time of uncertainty. And while I know this is health related, and I know it came on really fast, and I know there's not a whole lot of, hey, this is exactly what I should do. There wasn't a whole lot of that then either. But here's what I thought. I was an ordinary business owner that was doing my best to lead people through something that was unknown. Does that sound familiar? So adversity is adversity. At the end of the day, you find it, you locate it, you figure out what it is, you figure out how you can beat it, you strategize that, and then you execute. That doesn't change whether it's the housing crunch, whether it's the coronavirus, whether you're on a sales call trying to figure out how to sell it over top of a different company, a price objection, somebody on the phone not wanting to book a call. Adversity is adversity. And so just a few things that really helped me get my mind straight back then. We were able to, and when I say we, I definitely mostly mean them. I feel like all I really did was come in every day, 6:30 before anybody else did, look at my reflection in my computer monitor and go, it's all you, man. Like you have to lead these people through this. You led them to it. Now it's time to lead them through it. They chose to work for you. You're the leader now stand up and act like it. And so I did my best to do that, but I really feel like all I did was come in and turn the lights on and tell them they could do it. You know, that in that season, if you remember, the news was like it is now, like you didn't know what to believe. Most of it was negative. Most of it would have you just quitting, you know, giving up, so to speak. And so I just remember my daily communication with them was that we were going to get through it. We were going to stick together. We were going to triumph, and we were going to choose to be the ones that came out of that in the end and grew through it rather than failing through it. And we did. And again, all I really feel like I did personally, honestly, was show up and tell them they could do it, and they fixed all that stuff, and they brought the company through that. So. Don't overthink these things. There was a few rules we had. One, they weren't allowed to listen to the news. That literally, if you worked for me at that point in time, it was like, turn the news off, especially in the sales department. It was turn the news off. Why? Because those little seeds of negativity would get in and you can't help for them to start taking root and growing into negativity in your own life. I'm not saying that you can afford to not stay aware of what's going on right now. But when it comes to things that make you think that you can't get through this, or that you won't get through this, that is an immediate clue for you to turn whatever that is off. And for you to have a great second thought. And your second thought can be, well, even if I don't, I'm not going to strike out looking. And if you've ever played baseball, you step up to the plate and there's a pitcher there and that's your adversary, right? That's the person you're against and he's against you. And you look at him, and when you step up to the plate and he's the best pitcher on the other team, your first thought is, oh crap, he can strike me out. And your second thought has to be, well, it ain't going to be looking. I'm going to be swinging, and I'm going to swing one and hit one right over the fence. So guys, as leaders, as general managers, sales managers, call center managers, operations managers, owners, employees, whoever's watching this right now, listen to me and just listen. You're going to get through this. And it's your job to lead your team through it. And it's your job to be positive. And it's your job to find out how you beat the adversary, not how you lose to the adversary. One thing I always did is I always looked up quotes to make sure I wasn't crazy, right? To think that, you know what, who else said something like I'm trying to say to my team? And here's a couple that I found. This one is, always seek out the seed of triumph in every adversity. Always seek out the seed of triumph in every adversity. Back then, it was the economy. It was, you know, people bought a house or two and couldn't afford either. It was everybody selling their house. I mean, there was so many little adversities everywhere. We had to find the seed of triumph in every adversity. So where's the seed of triumph for you in this adversity? Because guess what? Let me give you a little hint. Every other company in town that does what you do, they're probably thinking like you are. How are we going to get through this? I'm going to have to mortgage my house. We're going to lose all the trucks. We're going to lose everything we just built. Oh my gosh, this is a giant step backwards, right? Because that's what the news is telling them to think. So if you're the one thinking positive, you're the one that's more likely to find the workaround. We're not in the want business. We're in the needs business. We're not selling Rolexes. We're not selling Rolls Royces. People need their houses fixed. And if every company in town is answering the phone negative and saying, no, we can't come out. Nope, the CDC said, and all these different things. And then you're answering the phone saying, hey, it's a great day at my roofing company. How can I serve you today? It might look a little different, but we're still going to serve you really well. Guess who's going to win? You're going to win, right? Again, it might look a little different. There might be some more costs involved. Heck, your average ticket might go down a little bit. Your closing might change a percentage or two. Or they'll go up because the rest of the town is doing what? They're running their business like they're going to lose. And you're going to run your business like you're going to win. The next one is from Nelson Mandela. I learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. The brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he who conquers that fear. I learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. If you're afraid, you have every reason to be afraid. But that's where courage kicks in. And that's where the decision kicks in, where you either say, I'm deciding to be a winner, or I'm not deciding to be a winner. So much of it is mental mindset. Waking up every day and telling yourself and telling your team, hey guys, it's going to look different, but we're going to get through this, and then we're going to tell the stories about it. As I look back, I can't sit here and reminisce about the good old days with just like positive stories or just like epic moments of non-adversity. Guess what I tell stories about? What you're listening to right now. I tell the stories of those seasons that we got through. So guys, right now, you're writing a story. You literally, if you're the leader of your company, the pen gets put in your hand every morning. You can either drop the pen and hope everything works out. It never does, FYI. You can take the pen and write down, this is never going to work. Why is this happening to me and my company? And you can write those things, or you can tear those pages out, ball them up, throw them into the fire and go, let me write this story the way I want to read it 3 years from now. One day I woke up, I walked into my office early, and I decided that me and my team, .. that we were going to win, period. So I just want to encourage you today. I know, there's adversity. Find the seed of triumph in this adversity and get out there and win. You can do it. I know you can do it. I'll see you on the other side, and we'll get to tell these stories together.